Love, friends. I think today we are going to consult on a very important subject of process and development of the faith from its birth to its glory and greatness and covering the world. You know that it is something very strange that the faith will grow with opposition. Maybe half of the work is done by Baha'is and half with the enemies. Or maybe they have the greater share, I don't know exactly. Baha'u'llah has said that these people, you know, when Baha'i faith started, these mullahs and others on the member, we call it, on the platform, they were shouting against the faith, and they said that wa shari'ata, wa waylah, the faith is gone, Islam is gone, and everything is and some are saying against Baha'i faith. Baha'u'llah said, these people, they are proclaiming the faith of Baha'u'llah, but they don't know themselves. Very interesting, that they were proclaiming the faith of Allah. Abdul Baha has said that when some people have some idea, right? And if you start to be against them, against that idea will get root. That idea will get stronger if you start opposing. Abdul Baha said that in Persia they start killing the believers, the Babis. And he said, from every single that they killed, a new 100 believers came up. It is true. The faith of God, you know, he has his own way too. I know a believer, a family of believers, they call it Sarvestani. This Sarvestani family, they are scattered in Persia, and they are in Arabia, pioneers in Arabia, a very, very wonderful family, the great family of the Baha'is. And I asked them, what happened that you come to the faith? They have a beautiful story. The story is that my grandfather, the young man telling me, my grandfather was in Sarvestan, is near Shiraz. And one day, it was a Nowruz, as he had put a very nice dress and very beautiful shoes on and white everything and went to the street. And he saw that they are killing a man. And he said, what is this man? They said, he's a Babi, you are killing him. He said, when they cut his neck, blood, you know, blood is spread everywhere, one drop of blood fallen in my shoes. And he said, in that, it shaken me. What is this? What is this religion? And I became a believer. He said, that one drop of blood make me a believer. I became a believer, and his family became a believer, and everybody became a believer. Now their children traveling all over the world, pioneering in Arabia. One drop of blood of the martyrs. Another man went in Isfahan, a young boy, 12 years old, went in Isfahan and went in the market and he said they are killing a believer. Shouting and killing, and this young boy seeing these martyrs, you know, full of life and light and steadfastness, he came back to his father and said, Father, I saw they were killing a very nice man. He was a wonderful man. He influenced my spirit. I don't know what to say. I don't know what to do. His father beaten him, you know. He said, do you want to say that you believe in the Babi faith? The boy said, yes, I believe, and I'm going out of this house. I'm not going to stay with you. I'm a different person. He left the house as a believer, 12 years old. You know who is that man? He's the grandfather of Mr. Kazemzadeh, who is the chairman of NSF United States. He's the grandfather of Mr. Arbab, who was secretary of NSF Persia. He's the grandfather of Dr. Arbab, who is doing in Colombia a very wonderful job. You know, all the family of Kazemzadeh, of Arbab, and so many from that one drop of the blood of the martyrs in Isfahan. A little boy tells us. The faith is progressing with opposition. Baha'u'llah has said that, Ashok Effendi has said that the water which, you know, which giving the life to the seed of the faith is blood of the martyrs. Now you think of the martyrs of Persia, 100 years back, what was happening? They said, I am a believer. All right, a good believer, a good martyr. Take care. What they have seen in the world, this martyr? They could not see the greatness of the world. Could they see? You know? They said, I am a believer, you must be killed. All right, still I believe. Kill me, doesn't matter. Still I believe. But that blood's gone, wasted? Could it be wasted in the world? Where is that blood? It's here. Isn't it? It's in you. You are the blood of the martyrs. The blood of the martyrs is growing in the world. From nation to nation. From country to country. From strand to strand. It's still pulsing. Every blood is dead except blood of the martyrs. Is alive. Is moving. Is pushing. The blood of the martyr is universal house of justice. The blood of the martyrs are heroes and conquerors of the world. Is the blood of the martyr wasted? I don't think so. The blood of the martyrs. Put your hands on your pulse. Can you? Can you find your pulse? Your pulse? Not your pulse. Can you? It's beating? This is blood of the martyrs. Blood of the martyr has changed your blood. So, the faith will grow with opposition. Amazing. Even you are speaking of mass conversion, no? Mass conversion, that the troops will come to the faith, thousands will come to that faith. Beloved Guardian said that it will happen through mass conversion that thousandfold, the Baha'i faith will progress thousandfold, numerically, materially, spiritual power, thousandfold. If you are thousand, you would be a million. If you are a million, you would be 1,000,000,000. Thousandfold is progressing. How? Beloved Guardian has said stages. It has stages. A stage by stage. He says that proclamation of the faith, no, the way he said is like that. I cannot say it in English, I'm sorry, you know, it is in Persian. First, that the faith would be with great strength, right? Establishment of the faith. Establishment of the faith is the first phase. Then second phase is a spread of the faith. The third phase is opposition. After opposition, great proclamation of the faith will come. So proclamation of the faith, wait for opposition. And after proclamation of the faith, Shoghi Effendi said, يَدْخُلُونَ فِي دِينَ اللَّهِ أَفْوَاجًا. Troops by troops, they will come to the faith. So opposition is a part of the progress of the faith. Without opposition, we could not have proclamation. Beloved Guardian has said about Europe. He said, in Europe, first we must try very much to spread the faith. And he has said certain area. Certain area, if you take a pencil, you can map it where Shoghi Effendi has said. He has said southern Germany, Italy, Greece, and this part, you know, islands of the Mediterranean. He said in this island, if we teach more, it will awaken our old religions, Catholic religion. It will awaken them. They will come out of their lethargy. This is the word Shoghi Effendi has said. They will start opposition. And Shoghi Effendi said, through the opposition, their opposition, Baha'i faith would be proclaimed. They said they can proclaim the faith in their capacity, that we cannot do that. It is out of our power to do the proclamation that they will do for us. And after that proclamation, after their opposition, that they proclaim the faith will come out of obscurity. The faith would be announced. When you say that don't listen to the Baha'is, Baha'is are so and so, everybody was interested to know what is the Baha'i faith. Abdul Baha has said that when in through the movement of Baha'i movement, you know, moving here and there, he said this would be the cause of talking. He says that your movement would be the cause of guftugu. I said in Persian, guftugu sababe jostuju. Jostuju sababe iman. when it is started, the people start talking, what is this? What's all about Guftugu? You know, they talk about it. Then when they talk about it a lot, they would be interested to investigate. What is this? After investigation, they become the believers. The same thing has happened in the first time in the martyrdom of the Persia. It happened all over the world again with opposition with all the religions, all the powers of the world. Material, physical, literature, spiritual, Abdu'l-Bahá has promised. All of them unitedly will arise against us. And Shoghi Effendi said that would be the cause of proclamation of coming of entry by truth. Alright, when we have opposition, what will happen to the faith? First thing, the Baha'is would be a better Baha'i. This is necessary for us. This is necessary that we ourselves will test our own faith. How much you are steadfast in the faith. Believers would be better believers. Abdu'l-Bahá has said that in the time of springtime, you know, and in the time of happiness and plenty, everybody is a friend. If it is in the time of the typhoons, you know, and if the time of hardness, hardship, if then somebody is a friend and devoting, he is a real friend. So our faith must be tested. It is written in Quran. It is written in Quran that do you think that you would not be tested just to say, I am a believer? Beloved Guardian has said that a test is necessary, you know, to separate the believers, the faithful, from the one who are shaking. It is necessary. Unfortunately, it is necessary for individual believers. Because the faith, it is the faith of God. It will grow with the sincere people, with truthful people. We want sincere and truthful people. On that base, the faith will grow. This is one result. Second result is this. Baha'i faith would be recognized. Recognition of the Baha'i faith is in the hand of our opposition. Baha'i faith, you know, would be born, would be recognized, would be separated, would be announced independence of his independent religion. This is the result, greatest result of opposition. I tell you one thing, that the way we are looking to the things and the way that Shoghi Effendi and Abdu'l-Bahá are looking to the things is so much different. In Egypt, Muslim court, you know, somebody died and they were going to put some burial ground and they asked for burial ground or marriage, some difficulties they have in Egypt in the time of Shoghi Effendi. So Baha'i court voted against Baha'i faith. Muslim court voted against Baha'i faith, right? And they announced Baha'i faith is different from Islam as Islam is different from Christianity. They have their own books, they have their own prophets, they have their laws. So as you do not call a Muslim a Christian, you cannot call a Baha'i a Muslim, right? And the Baha'is went to the court of appeal, you know, they appealed, and higher court said the same thing. Yes, we agree that the Baha'is are separate, and this and that, condemned, you know, they are kafirs, they are mushriks, they are this, but they are separate from Islam, right? And Baha'is of Egypt, they were start crying, you know, very much crying. What happened? Baha'i faith is this, and they condemn us, very much unhappy. But Shoghi Effendi, it was the greatest document in the hand of Shoghi Effendi. I tell you, after the writings of Baha'u'llah and Abdu'l-Bahá, Shoghi Effendi liked that document. It is true. He made such a great publicity for that letter, you know? Such a great publicity he made. He was so happy. He said, a document, Court of Islam, recognizing Baha'i faith as an independent religion. It's true, you know, because court of Egypt, you know, is the highest court in the world in Islam. They clearly recognize, even the court of appeal, that it is true, the Baha'i faith is an independent. This is what we want to take it. Abdu'l-Bahá said, the universe is in test. Universe is in test. Test is for universe, is for the faith, is for individual. The faith of God will go through the test. Individuals will go. Abdu'l-Bahá said, my bones are burning from the test. Test is for everyone. After ascension of Abdu'l-Bahá, Shoghi Effendi has quoted a verse from the Bab. I think I have told you once that verse. تَلَّهُ تُفْتَنُ كُلُّ شَيْءٍ فِي كُلُّ شَيْءٍ مِنْ كُلُّ شَيْءٍ إِلَىٰ كُلُّ شَيْءٍ بِنَفْسِ كُلُّ شَيْءٍ تَلَّهُ تُفْتَنُ كُلُّ شَيْءٍ The meaning is this. I swear by God. Not I swear by God. It means swear to God, you know. It is not positive. It is, what do you call it?
I swear upon God.
I swear upon God. تَلَّهُ it means swear upon God. Tuftano, it means that it's tested. Is tested. Is tested. Tested. Is tested, you know? Test. T-E-S-T. Is tested. Koloshe, it means everything. Tested. Tuftano, it means is tested. Koloshe, it means everything. So what is the meaning so far? Everything is tested. Now how everything is tested? Is tested like this. Everything is fi kullu shay, in everything. Everything is tested in everything. Fi kullu shay, it means from everything. Men, it means from. Men kolloshe, from everything. Ela kolloshe. Ela, it means toward. Toward. Towards everything. Towards everything. The nafse kullu shay, in itself by itself. Itself by itself. So, you see what is the meaning of the test? The Bab. This is the verse of the Bab. Tallahe toftano. Let us read it together. Tallahe. تفتنو كل شيء في كل شيء من إلى بنفسه So friends here we are Everything by everything. Everything in it. So I tell you my own story. All right? You don't write it down. Okay? Sometime I was praying this way. I said, oh God, don't make anybody a test for me. You know, I said, don't make anybody a test for me. Because if he's good, it's a test for me. If he's bad, it's a test for me. If he's praised, it's a test for me. You know? Don't make a test for me from others. I do not want to be tested with others. Leave me alone. If he is good for himself, if he is bad for himself, if he is praised for himself, don't make a test for me. Please, please. This was my first prayer. And I was very happy that I am safe. No test for me. Nobody is a test for me. Later on I discovered not only the people may be a test for me, I am a test for the people. Then I prayed, I said, oh God, don't make me a test for others. True. I said, my good action or bad action, my mistakes or whatever, don't make me a test for. Please save the people, be tested by me. This was my prayer. Then I saw this letter from the Bab that even I am a test for myself. I didn't know that. You know, even you are a test for yourself. Many people are tested for no reason, you know, by themselves. That is, I think, the worst thing if you are tested by yourself. Now I am praying, oh God, don't make me a test for anybody. Don't make anybody a test. Don't make a test for myself. Don't make them a test for themselves. You see, this is the word of the Baal, that by God, he's, you know, swearing to God. God may test everything in everything, everything in it, everything in himself, everything for others, every other thing for them. You know, everything towards everything is a test. When you know that, when you know this verse of the Baal, if you are in test, you chant this prayer. I do so. If something happened to me, whole night, 2 hours, I pray. It is a prayer for me. By God, everything is a test for everything. And I pray that may God save me from this test. It is true. So which one of you know this by heart now so far? Now, in the writings, we have the question of steadfastness. What is the meaning of steadfastness? No, they said in the time of test, you must be steadfast. The meaning of steadfastness, Baha'u'llah himself has said, what is the meaning? In Persia, we call it istiqamat, istiqamat kubra, great steadfastness. Baha'u'llah in the book of Aqdas, he said, what is the meaning of great steadfastness? And he's calling the believer to hang on great steadfastness. Baha'u'llah has made it very simple, very, very simple. What is steadfastness? Baha'u'llah said steadfastness is this. That you must believe, I wish I could remember that verse by heart. Exact verse of Baha'u'llah, maybe we can find it amongst the Persians. But the meaning is this. That the great steadfastness is this. That you must believe whatever is revealed from the pen of Baha'u'llah. Whatever, you know. Baha'u'llah has said, to heaven is earth, and to earth is heaven, you must believe it. This is the meaning of steadfastness. Don't bring your judgment in the word of God. You see, don't bring your judgment, your personal thing in the... Say the word of God is beyond and above my word, above my understanding. Whatever is revealed from the pen of God, you know, it is infallible. Whatever. Right? Now, in the time of Baha'u'llah, if somebody says that the heaven is earth and earth is heaven, Baha'u'llah has said so in the book of Aqdas, you must believe it. They say, how earth can be heaven and heaven can be earth? No. Now we know in science that there is no heaven, there is no earth. The heaven is earth, the earth is heaven. Isn't it? Yeah. All these stars are earth, and we are another star. In that time, you know, that science was not discovered, and we said, what possible? Earth is heaven, heaven is earth? Now we see even that word is the right word. Even that word is a right. Every heaven is an earth, every earth is a heaven. In that time, maybe, 100 years back, they couldn't think of it. After 100 years, the meaning of the word of Baha'u'llah is clear. Even heaven is earth, earth is heaven. So can any doubt in the writings? So when the test is coming, you must be steadfast. What is steadfast? To hang on the writings. See, what is in the writings? Believe in the writings. In another word, in another tablet, Baha'u'llah has said like this. I think I have told you this sometime back. Baha'u'llah has said that my faith is great. Meanwhile, it's simple. It's great and simple. He says the greatness of the faith I have revealed in other tablets. In many tablets he has revealed of the greatness of his faith, no? Can you say one instance of his greatness of his faith? One word, one sentence, one idea? Why Baha'i faith is so great? Can you say one sentence of his greatness?
He's able to unite.
Sure. Baha'u'llah himself has said so. He said, one of the signs of my greatness of my faith is this, that every 500,000 years once this revelation will come. 100,000 years. It means every 5,000 centuries. Other religions, 10 centuries. Every 5,000 centuries, once my faith will come. Baha'u'llah has said that I cannot say more. He said, if I say more, you know, the people can't take it. I tell you just one thing, that every 5,000 centuries, once a revelation like my revelation will come. This is the greatness of the faith of Baha'u'llah. That Shoghi Effendi said, present generation cannot understand, cannot grasp the greatness of the faith. We cannot. Can we? You know, we are so near to the faith to see the greatness and then. However, Baha'u'llah said, my faith is great, but it's very simple. Then he said, the simpleness of my faith is this, to see everything with the eyes of God, not with your own eyes. It is another way of saying steadfastness. No? To say everything with the eyes of God, not with your own eyes. انظروا في بأين الله لا بأيونكم بأين الله. أين الله means eyes of God, vision of God, sight of God. See everything with the sight, with vision, with the eye of God, not with your own vision, not your own understanding. This is the meaning of steadfastness. Now, Baha'u'llah said, if you reach to that level to see everything with the eyes of God, you are exempted from any test. Anybody, yes, anybody can reach that level in his faith, no test for him. Glad tidings. This is the meaning of steadfastness. Another thing Shoghi Effendi said. Shoghi Effendi said, the amount of the bounties of God toward us is equal to the amount of our opposition. The amount of the bounties of God is equal to our opposition and oppressions. Is it right, oppressions? Uh-huh. Oppressed. Oppressed or oppression. You know, the more we are in difficulties, the more we are successful. Even sometimes you don't see, you don't think, you don't believe, you know, so what happened? How possible? How possible we are in oppression and the faith will progress more? How? I tell you how. Maybe somewhere in the world, you know, the Baha'is are under difficulties, right? But some other place in the world, it's coming up. You know, the victories will be some other place of the world. You don't see, you know, you see only the difficulties. But somewhere else in the world is coming up. And Baha'u'llah has said, he said that if you extinguish this light, extinguish. If you extinguish this light on the land, it will come out of the middle of the ocean. It will come out of the middle ocean, and he will say, I am the life giver. I am the life givers of the world. Enni muhyal alamin. I am the life givers of the world. My message, he said, it will not remain underground. You push it down here, it will come somewhere else. So if somewhere have difficulties and oppositions, it would be a source of enthusiasm to other believers. They do mass conversion, they will cry, they will pray. Because the Baha'i faith, you know, is one faith. When it is oppressed, when it is attacked, you know, it will be braver some other parts of the world. All the victories of 10-year crusade we have, because of some opposition in Persia. In 1955, they killed 8 Persians in Persia. And that killing 8 Persians in Persia was the cause of a very great progress throughout the world. I tell you, mass conversion started from that 8 believers. In Gilbert, in Mentawai, in West Africa, when mass conversion started, it was exactly 55 after the martyrdom of these eight people in Persia. It will come up. You know, this is what Beloved Guardian has said. This is what Baha'u'llah has promised. You cannot extinguish this light. So, what else? And then again, Beloved Guardian said, every setback, you know, it would be cause a further progress. When he was announcing 2-year plan in Africa to Baha'is of England, Britannia, he told them very clearly, he said, now you are going to make a plan in Africa to conquer Africa. But from the very first start, I tell you, you would have many setbacks. Don't you think everything is arranged for you? You have many setbacks, but every setback would be a cause of further progress. Also, Beloved Guardian has said that you have some difficulties, right? You pray so much, you try so much, you cannot solve the problem. He said, don't worry. We cannot solve, many problems could not be solved, you know? But your very prayers, your very effort would be answered some other way, in this way or other way. So we must not think that it is easy to change the world and it is, we are going to talk, we are taking a lawyer, we are going to court. You may do all of things, still you cannot solve the problem. You know, because everything is in the hand of Baha'u'llah. He knows what to do, where to do, how, when to do. He knows it. You know, he is the owner of his faith, he is his organ. I was telling you that you must see everything with the eyes of God, not with your own eyes, right? This time, you must see everything with the eyes of the House of Justice, not with your own eyes. You must put House of Justice first, instructions of the House of Justice first. Whatever it is, you know, loyal to the word of the House of Justice. And what is happening, you know, what is happening? The end is victory. What happened? Maybe in the beginning, you know, you don't see the bright of it, the greatness of it, but later on you will see how very correct was the word of the House of Justice. Up to date yourself, you know, with the word of the House of Justice. So thank you very much. If you have only one or two or three questions, with the permission of our chairman, I answer. This beautiful Aslis are waiting. Yes, on this question. You know, for example, Baha'u'llah said unity of mankind, right? If you see through the eyes of Baha'u'llah, you believe in unity of mankind. If you see with your own eyes, you said, how black and white could be friends, how yellow and brown could be one, how Japanese is going to sit with Indians and Africans, you know? You make so many questions. Don't see with your own eyes. See through the eyes of Baha'u'llah, mankind is one. You know, in everything, in every question you have in your mind, see what Baha'u'llah has said. See through the eyes of God what Baha'u'llah is seeing the world. Not your personal, you know, your personal understanding or your personal believing, you know. You see through the eyes of God, not through your own eyes. It is very great, very great. Yes. Difficult?
No, I was just thinking.
You try.
I was just thinking that we also tell other people that Baha'u'llah has said this is the age of reason and we must think things out. And this is exactly the opposite.
No. You know, we have two phases. One is one phase of investigation. In the phase of investigation, you must do all the reasoning. You know, we must investigate in your own way. Somebody accepting the Baha'i faith through the prophecies, right? Somebody accepting the faith through principles. Somebody accepting the faith to the needs of the world. Somebody has a spiritual feeling that the Lord is come. It's up to you. Investigate everything before being Baha'i. When you sign as I am a Baha'i, a firm Baha'i, you must follow the writings. You know? However, you must investigate the truth till end of the life, you know? But that investigation is in life, in belief, you know? In not is investigation in... You are investigating to develop yourself. To know more, you know, to adjust yourself with the writings. You are not investigating to question the writings. When you call yourself a believer, you know, I am a believer in Baha'u'llah, whatever he says. If he says peace is peace, if he says war is war. I believe in Baha'u'llah, you know, this is my... Now, before you have all the things to investigate, everything, years. We have some people 13 years investigating. Why not? Some people I saw 23 years investigating became Baha'i. Some people in 5 minutes said, I feel it is true. Some people, before telling him anything, he come to me and said, don't you have any message for me? I am waiting for the message this morning. Many has happened. So the people are different. But once we accept the fact, you know, we accept the Baha'u'llah as manifestation of God, then you must see everything through his eyes. Another question? Great patient. Alaykum bi sabri jameel. Be patient, be patient, be patient. You know, the time will solve the problem. All this crisis will go, will come and will go. Be patient in that time. And then Baha'u'llah says this. Baha'u'llah says that. For every attribute that you have, there is a reward. You know? Everything is a reward. You are a good man, you are a reward. You are serving, you have a reward, right? But he says, for patience, to be patient, there is no reward. There is so great reward, you know, it is not accountable. You cannot count how much reward you have when you are patient. The patient has a reward, great reward, not equal with any other thing. You may sacrifice, you may be martyr, you may everything. Patience is greater. Alaykum bi sabr jameel. Remain in a beauty patient. Right? Anything happen, be patient. You know? God is working. It is out of your hand. But it is not out of the hand of God. God himself is solving the problems. Time will solve the problem. Yes, please.
There is so much of anti-Baha'i literature around, and many of them succeed and all that. Could you tell how to contract, how to deal with this problem?
Yes. You know, there are so many things coming against the faith, right? First of all, don't read them. I do not read a word from enemies of the faith. Not a word. Somebody said, but you are a hand of the cause. You must protect the faith. I said, yes, I protect the faith. But first, I protect my own soul. Isn't it? You should protect yourself first. How you are protecting yourself first and bring a dirty book in your house, in your family, your wife, your children, you know, and said, I'm investigating, you know, to know better to answer. No, you do not need to know all these things. Somebody is cursing you, somebody is cursing your prophet, somebody is cursing your religion. Why you need to read? Believe me, one sentence I have not seen. So many books, you know, in Persia written, hundreds of books against it. I have not seen that. First, protect yourself. Secondly, if you have asked something, you know the faith to answer. Why you need to know that the first? We know what they are saying to tell us. They are saying we are false prophets. We know we are not false prophets. You know? We know that we are universal. We know that we are... So this is what Beloved Guardian said. In opposition comes, you have a chance to show to the people that we are universal. We are supernational, supranational, supernatural, non-political. You know? It means we are beyond any borders. We are something universal. And it is divine originally, we know that. Right? And we are non-political. We have no relation with anything. Not east, not west, not this, not that. We are just impartial. Non-political, universal religion. This is the nature of the faith. Anybody wants to know? Welcome. Anybody wants to know more? These are other books. Please study the Baha'i books. Right? But, the House of Justice says, the believers must be answered. If some of the believers come to you and said, I have a difficulty, somebody says so and so, what to do? Then sit with him, open the books, study the writings. If you cannot find the answer, go to someone else, go to your board members, go to your local assemblies, go to national assemblies, you know. Even if you have some bigger difficulties, write to the House of Justice. Why not? You know? But don't go and investigate what they are saying, you know. Don't go and say that I'm reading the book, you know, to do this, to do that. It is not our way. Just ignorance. Ignore them is the best. Any other question? Thank you very much. Allah.